This is Alan Hatfield here at NEB 2018 at the Moza booth, and we have Kevin, and you've got a Moza iPhone gimbal.
It's called the Mini Me, no relation to Austin Powers. And I'll just show you how easy it is. We just put your phone in here, and you just turn it on. And it's going to sense what type of phone is in there, if you have a Samsung, if you have an iPhone. And what's really amazing about this gimbal, if you have one of these new age smartphones, it will actually wirelessly charge the phone while you're recording with it.
Will it?
Pretty amazing tech.
So you need an iPhone 10.
Or a Samsung 8. Right. Or like the iPhone, whatever the next one is.
Yes,
when this
comes out. Exactly. Yeah, because my phone's a 7. That's what we're using right now is an iPhone 7.
Mm-hmm.
And that's a 7 Plus.
Yeah.
So you can see it holds the 7 Plus beautifully. And so if it can hold that, it can pretty much hold anything.
It can pretty much hold anything. We designed this in a way where whatever cameras happen to hit, whatever new phones will hit the market, you can adjust it and make it fit for whatever size phone you might have or whatever size phone Apple happens to put out next year.
Well, I want to play with it. So.
Definitely. The gimbal itself goes for $109.
Oh, thank you.
Which is pretty good price considering that you can do the wireless charging.
Right.
Another nice feature is you see that dial right there.
Yes.
The one below it allows you to control ISO and focus if you're using the Filmic Pro app.
Ah, yes.
You can also control a variety of other things. And for me, it's a really big deal because instead of doing the focus on my phone where I'm having to push the button all the time, instead I can just scrub it using my thumb while I'm holding it. So I think it will make my shots way more stable and just overall way better using this device.
This looks pretty stable to me.
The rack focus ability on it, I think, is super essential because often if you want to try and do a shot where you're jumping back and forth to the focus, it's a bit tricky with the iPhone right now having to click on the screen. So this really eases that up and makes it much better. Another nice feature of it is if you happen to have our cool tripod battery pack here, you can charge your gimbal while you're using it.
Can you?
So this is new state-of-the-art tech right here. It is a tripod with batteries built into it.
Oh, my God.
It's using USB and micro USB, so you can actually plug in two things and keep it powered on. It's really new tech. I don't know anyone who's built something like this where there's battery in the tripod. If you find anyone at NEB who has a battery in the tripod, I'll pay you $50.
Oh, okay.
That's how much this costs, by the way.
That is so cool to have the...
It's really a game changer because for someone like me who shoots a lot of 360 video, I often tether a battery underneath it with Velcro. And now it's like, oh, all I have to do is bring my tripod and I can power it up. So it's really a big save in terms of you don't need to carry as much with you on a shoot. And it's just really neat. You're going to see every major tripod company adopting this design in the next year or two. So Manfrotto, Joby, you guys know who did it first.
Yeah. Very, very, very cool.
Yeah.
I like that a lot. And what did you say the price was?
So the price is $109 for the Mini Me. For the tripod with batteries, that's $50.
Okay.
So overall, like around $160.
I know.
Isn't really bad considering some of these other gimbals on the market are $300 and don't do half the features that this does.
Right. And how long does it last without the Mini Me?
Without extra charge, it will last about 8 hours. So pretty long battery life on there. Honestly, I think if you plug this in and charge it, you can go for a lot longer. And then if you really want to get crazy, you can take another battery, attach it to that, charge that one, and you go even infinite.
Okay.
So a nice feature with this is that you can do slow time-lapse exposure. So if you set this up and you want to shoot a 24-hour exposure, you would be able to pull that off with enough battery life circulating to it.
That is very, very, very cool.
Yeah.
So thank you for showing this to me. I really appreciate that, Kevin. And this is Alan Hatfield here at NAB 2018 for Personal View. We've been at the Moza booth. And subscribe to your channel, and we'll see you later.